Today we are gonna turn this to something like this with the free Snapseed app. We are gonna try replicating motion blur on this image. It works pretty well in certain cases considering we are editing on mobile. Starting with basic edits to recover details, in tune image, increasing saturation for more color, reducing highlights, and also shadows to give the image more contrast. With curves, I'm gonna try correcting some colors. You can notice a slight red tint in the image, bringing down a bit. Also green. I'm gonna save this. To create motion blur, first I have to remove the motorcycle rider to get better results. So trying the healing tool here. Not working well here. I'm gonna close this. Now I'll try replicating cloning tool from Photoshop to get rid of the motorcycle. Going to double exposure tool, I'm gonna add the last saved image. It is added here. Now I'm gonna move it to the right, maintaining the alignment on the lane. Trying here to get the sample of the road from the new image on the motorcycle underneath. Increasing the opacity to 100. Applying it. Then going to masking screen. Tapping on the stacks icon, view edits, the latest double exposure and brush. Here with the double exposure hidden and with the brush value set at 100, brushing on these parts to reveal the road applied from the new image. Trying to clear the head here. There is still some parts of this motorcycle left. Again, saving this as a copy. Adding the same as a new double exposure image. Again, moving and aligning it further to the right. Repeating the steps to clear the road. Repeating the same step again to completely clear the road of the motorcycle. Here we have not got the perfect result, but this should be enough to get the final look. To replicate the motion blur effect, I'm gonna use the perspective tool and select the scale option and drag the image horizontally, which basically stretches the image from the center, repeating the same till I get the desired motion blur effect. After repeating the perspective tool 4 times, adding the earlier saved image with the double exposure tool, increasing the opacity to 100, going to the masking screen. Here with the effect disabled and brush value at 100, just brushing in the middle to reveal the rider. Then with brush value set at 0, carefully brushing out around the rider and the motorcycle to reveal the motion blur effect behind. gonna keep the soft shadow, which gives the image a more natural look. To remove that spot on the left, you can use the earlier cloning method if healing tool doesn't give the desired results. The changes after each effect applied. And the final result. Thanks for watching.